What is the most desperately lonely thing you have ever done? I would probably say replying to my own post. Similar situation here, dude. I like to respond my own comments. OMG, are we the same person? I do the exact same thing. I would definitely say that creating this post with the express purpose of writing this comment chain was the most desperate thing I've ever done. I like you. I has been several months since I had actual human contact. I am a trucker, five hat stays out for months at a time, and the quarantine came just as I was gonna go home, so I can't until it is lifted. I put a pillow in a coat that was hung up and hugged it. It must be tough being away for your family for so long on the road. I respect you for doing that job. When I took care of men in the hospital, I didn't realize how often men go without contact, especially physical, and it was heartbreaking. I used to sometimes volunteer at elderly communities and give foot or hand massages. I had a few men break down crying, held my own hand while going to sleep, hugged my pillow and pretend it's a woman. I hugged my pillow and pretended it was my boyfriend, which doesn't exist, you're not alone. Thanks for making me feel less like a loser. Asking my doctor to tell my work I could only work certain hours because of my depression, when that's only half true. When I get home, everyone is asleep and I'm very lonely, so by the way of my doctor forcing my job to give me the schedule one once so I can get home when my family is still awake and I won't be so lonely. I've known psychiatrists to do this for nurses and machinists, edit, and first responders. Buy something for myself and ask for it to be gift wrapped. Oof, that is too real. Then drive across town to mail it back to your address right before they close so it will arrive a few days later. Ordering pizza and ask them to write, "I love you," inside the box. For my girlfriend, I live alone after my fiancé left me for another guy a few years ago. I just wanted to read those words in another handwriting than my own again. I think you win. I'm really social and have good interactions with people around me, from cashiers to family members. I believe most people would see me as an outgoing and type personality, when in reality, I always feel like I'm on the outside looking in and wonder how I can be so lonely while being surrounded by so many people. If anyone ever wants or just needs someone to talk to, whether it be something serious or just mindless chatter, hell, even if you just need someone to say hi to, my inbox is always open. Do you think people see the real you? Let me preface this by saying I'm generally a happy person in life. A positive attitude has always been one of my strengths. I do, of course, go through the whole range of emotions like anyone else. I think people see a muted version of the real me, and that's primarily self-inflicted because I have a real lack of self-confidence at times. This prevents me from seizing opportunities or just being comfortable enough at times to let people in. I'm just a few small personal victories away from boosting that confidence. If I can't believe in myself in the end, how can I expect others to? It's something I'm actively working on. It's a good question. Thank you for asking. Many a times, even when we're not alone, we feel lonely. I hope you make it through. I went on Omegle a few days ago. That's not too bad. Sometimes I do that when it's the middle of the night and there is nobody to talk to. Plus, with COVID-19, it's harder to get out and see your friends. So you shouldn't feel bad about using Omegle. Hard to get past all those dicks though. Got back together with my ex. I only ever did that once though. Nostalgia is a deceitful cunt. I went to the grocery store so that I could hear someone talk to me when I was being rung up. I used to work in a pharmacy, and a lot of the older people that would come in would stand at talk for ages, even when I was done with their purchase advice. A lot of the time they lived alone and it was the only interaction they would have in the week. Broke my heart, and I loved chatting to them and knowing how happy it made them. Monsieur, I hope you're less lonely now. Yikes, that's kinda funny but also sad. I hope you're not feeling so lonely now. I sat in a class discussion of a different class just to talk to a girl and still didn't ask her for her number. created two different accounts to talk to myself. Shish. You're not supposed to tell them that. You don't tell me what to do. Yes, I do now. Shut up. No. Slaps myself. I said shut up. Fine, I'll stop. I sent myself flowers once. Complete with a secret admirer card. Sure, if I want flowers, I can just buy flowers. But there's a difference between just buying flowers and receiving flowers. That is pretty tragic, I have to admit. I often end up imagining going out and having fun with friends. Talk to myself. I seem to do it all the time. Perhaps I'm mental. I don't know. I wish I had friends. Haha, idiot, no one likes you. Yes, I know. I'll just keep talking to myself then. I can't go to bed without hugging my pillow like I am cuddled up to woman in bed. I've only dated one girl, but I more or less got addicted to sharing a bed with someone. Wait until you start to see your pillow in a different way. Each day it passes, that pillow seems more and more attractive. I once called my cell phone from my parents' phone just to hear it ring. You've dredged up a memory. When I was a teenager, a couple of decades ago, I was sometimes so lonely and bored in the summer holidays that I just call a random number from our house phone hoping to have a random conversation with someone. That's cool, TBH. I created an imaginary situation where I'm in a relationship and my GF does something asshole-ish. Then posted it on r, am I the asshole? From the perspective of said GF so that people will talk about how great of a BF I am and how she doesn't deserve me. Oh dear God, could you link the post? All of that sub is a creative writing exercise. I paid a prostitute $800 for 45 minutes of spooning. May I ask why so much? Desperation is a sad cologne. I get drunk so I don't have to think about how lonely I am, monsieur. I mean, participating in this sub has to be in the top 5. I am in no way creative but was super bored when my shift hours went down by 100 hours a month that I started painting by numbers. I've played that game once. It is quite satisfying to play but it was too tedious for me and I got bored of it quickly. I would prefer to play it if it had sort of puzzle element to it. **** proceeds to play 100s of hours of Picross Touch **. Chatting with Google Assistant, pretending it's a real person and play games with it. Asking it to make jokes. Sing or read something. Removing Instagram because you have no followers. Go to the movies by myself. See, I love going to the movies alone. If I go with my girl, I'm explaining everything to her or she falling asleep on me. Either way, distracting me from the flick. If I'm with my buddies, it's not like I'm talking with them anyway. I don't understand why a lot of people are afraid to go to the movies alone. I can understand a pub or restaurant, but it's not like you have to interact during the movie at all. You're in a dark room for 2 hours watching the screen, eating a snack inside a restroom cubicle, sad face. I can understand. High school flashbacks. Wrote a journal to my future self. I could send photos if you DM me. But basically I grew up in an abusive household with a dad suffering with PTSD and a mom who struggled to keep her family dream from falling apart. Dealing with the kind of remarks and events from my past kind of fucked me up. But the journal basically said that if I ever made it to the 12th grade without committing suicide or ruining my life with or over some bullshit, I should reflect on my past and know that the me who wrote the journal loves them and is proud of who they became, and that even though you're my parents never told me, that he me was proud of me. On a brighter note, I read that journal yesterday. I'm an upcoming senior who is waiting enlistment into the army. My dream job. I like to think that the past me can envision this and know he would make it. All the kid really needed was a hug, man. I talk to myself like I'm giving an interview of things that I would like to happen but likely never will. I let a door-to-door vacuum cleaner salesman give me a demo. When I was younger, I once went and put my dirty clothes into a jacket and pair of pants so I could pretend I had someone to hug, cry on. Now I just become unstable and talk so much and push everyone away and then go, why does nobody talk to me? Held a stranger's hand. That sounds extremely awkward. We ended up dating, lol. This is the funniest thing ever. Have a gold award. Thank you, I really appreciate it. Became a smoker. It makes me feel like I have absolutely failed at life. I have quit for months to years at a time when life is a good start again when things get stressful or sad. My friends once had an overnight party that I wasn't invited to, and they put a bunch of pictures up on their Snapchat stories, party with the boys, etc. I felt pretty left out cause they were my best and only friends at the time, and so I took a picture of my couch, drew two stick figures on it, as a joke of course I'm completely sane, and put it on my story with the same caption. Even though I meant it as a joke, I was really hurt that I wasn't even told about this party that was organized by my best friends, and spent the rest of the night alone playing video games and crying. Years ago I broke up with a girlfriend. She was great, but my mother was dying and so I was emotionally numb and broke up with her. I realized the mistake after my mother died and tried to get her back. She had moved on. She was kind, fun and beautiful and had no end of potential suitors, so no real surprises. I dislocated my shoulder boxing and had keyhole surgery. A few days after release from surgery I was alone and went to a family-run Vietnamese restaurant in my massive shoulder sling and foam block. The busy and beautiful Vietnamese family, a lovely extended family unit with kids, just watched me eat alone, using chopsticks and spoon with only my left hand. I so wanted to be part of the family at that point. I miss my mother, my family, my friends. At that point, halfway through my malcoordinated meal, my girlfriend and her new man walked past the restaurant window, laughing and clearly having a great time. And good for them really, but goddamn that was lonely. I was younger. These days I'd know to talk to my friends or family, organize myself with them so I'm not alone during a vulnerable time, keep busy, etc. Literally nothing in your story is shameful or embarrassing at all. Not a single fucking thing. Embarrassment score 0. I originally was gonna make a YT animated show with 3 different people, but they wouldn't exist. And it was just me pretending to be 3 different people. Being jealous when I see animals, people getting affection, because I get none. Try getting a dog. They're truly God's gift to humanity. Craigslist sex. Back when Craigslist had personals, nice things did not generally result from that process. Usually some combination of old, fat, length. I used to love digging through the casual encounters section trying to spot the bots, catfishers, and fake accounts. Kiss my pillow. IDK it accounts, but I took an overdose of pills on Thursday night. My mental state reached breaking point again. I was desperately lonely and wanted it all to stop. I chickened out before taking a lethal amount and I've been experiencing the typical symptoms of poisoning ever since. Whilst this gets out of my system is sure, I can't say I feel any better or even worse. I kinda just feel numb. IDK how I meant to feel. I'm just empty. I am glad that you are still here with us. You may not see it, but there are so many people around you that love you and care about you. You might think that the world is better without you, or that nobody would care if you passed away, but that just isn't true. I hope you find the light at the end of this tunnel. If you need someone to talk to, I would suggest sending a message to you, Conflict Donuts, who has kindly offered to talk to anyone feeling lonely right now. You definitely need help of an expert. Please report it to a hospital if you can. Don't let mental illness take your life. There are available treatments that will help. This is not a low point of your life, but just a high point in your depression. You can start over anytime. Don't miss the chance to get better. Paid people on Fiverr to talk with me. I saved a voicemail from a person at my last apartment complex letting me know what I should do with my key before I leave. At the end she says my name and tells me to have a good day. IDK, it's probably because she sounds so genuine. I used to listen to it a lot before I changed phones and couldn't access it anymore. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.